The Victoria Foundation was first alerted to food insecurity in the capital region via data in the 2012 Vital Signs report. And that report stated that 50,000 people in our region are food insecure. That means these people do not have access to healthy food. They depend on food banks, emergency food hampers, meal programs. And this supports 20,000 people in our region annually, but it leaves behind 30,000 people, the hidden hungry, that do not have access to these services or are unable to feed themselves and their families. The foundation began giving grants to the Mustard Seed in 2013 for the purpose of exploring a food distribution network. Over time, the Food Share Network was born and now is focusing more on sustainability and self-reliance. And the final piece of the puzzle for the foundation was to create this, a food distribution center that realizes fresh, perishable food coming in every day, sorted and cleaned by the Mustard Seed, then sent on to the Food Share Network and its partners and out to the people that really need it. And look where we are today. This is absolutely amazing. To me, it's the most extraordinary example of when people come together to work together to help others. This is the result.
So the Food Share Network was formed in order to enhance cooperation and collaboration in order to address food security in the capital region. It's a collaboration among funders, donors, Food Share Network partners, community centers, food banks, and food retailers. We want to have less people coming to food banks and more people connecting to food in their community. We want this food to result in healthier communities, more resilient communities, and increased access to healthy, culturally appropriate food. I want to recognize the important contributions of Food Share Network members towards this large-scale collaborative project. It is only through their contributions of time and energy that we've been able to achieve this regional goal together. Food Share Network membership now stands at over 60 members. When this facility was opened in March of 2017, 23 of those members were participating in the Food Rescue Project. As of today, over 43 members are participating in this project. And I think that really speaks to the impact that this is having on our community and really the strength of the collaboration and cooperation among all of the partners who made this happen. So the Food Rescue Project is reducing hunger in our community. This is being done by collaboration between the Food Share Network, Thrifty Foods, the Victoria Foundation, the Mustard Seed, and Rotary Clubs of Greater Victoria. This food is used by participating Food Share Network members to support the community programs that are happening through their organization. As a result of the Food Rescue Project, there has been a substantial increase in perishable food that is available to low-income folks through Food Share Network members. We are really excited about the prospect of connecting this food to hidden hungry people in our community. And we're particularly interested in making this food available to kids through schools, Indigenous communities, and vulnerable seniors. Approximately 4,000 pounds of fruits, vegetables, and dairy are recovered and redistributed 6 days a week. And less than 10% of this food actually ends up going to landfills. So the Food Rescue Project is having a huge impact in our community. We are reaching the most vulnerable people. It's taken a lot of work to get here, and I know we are all committed to continuing to work together.
Ultimately, we believe in a future that focuses less on the symptoms of food insecurity and more on the root causes. This is an opportunity for all of us. Here we are, delivering that now, seeing more sustainable food being delivered to the people that need it. But this work has to continue. Moving forward, we recognize funding is necessary to continue this incredible program. But there's room for all of us to participate. You can donate your time, you can donate food, or you can donate funds to the Food Security Fund. This is an extraordinary opportunity for all of us. Let's work towards a food secure region.